candidates are here in area three. So we've got, as we did in the first session, we have some formulated questions that we're gonna go through. And our moderator for this session is gonna be Ms. Kathleen Shaw. So just give her a pause. Well, also, let me take some pressure off of her. Because of the time, she has another commitment, so I may be filling in for her for the last question or two if I need to. So I wanna put that out there so she doesn't have to take some pressure off of her. Thank you, Kathleen.
Again, thank you so much for being here today. The ground rules are, each candidate will have 60 seconds. Your first question will be to be a brief introduction in 60 seconds. Muriel Sykes will be holding up a green, red, or yellow card. It can go over your time or what have you. Each candidate will be asked a question. There are some that will be designated for State Center Community College and some for Fresno County Office of Education. That's why we have them in front of you, so we'll go through that as we do. Each question will be 90 seconds to answer. Then you will have 60 seconds at the end to give closing remarks. Again, thank you so much for being here with us today. We do appreciate your service.
I will be here some of the time, I'm sure Ms. Sykes is here.
And yes.
Thank you so much. All right, if we can start with our 60-second introduction, starting with the first candidate, Eric Kinney.
Good morning, my name is Eric Payne. I'm a representative for State Center Community College District, representing Area 2, and it's always good to be here at Fresno Temple. My grandparents were ministers in this church, and it just represents such a historical piece to this community that I live in and that I come from. I was born and raised here in Fresno, California. I went to West Fresno Elementary School, and then a graduate of Washington Union High School. And eventually, I wanted to go out and better serve my community, and I went to Alabama A&M University, where I majored in my undergraduate career in biology and my graduate career in biology as well. And I was doing some work as an educator in Huntsville City Schools. And that work, I felt like I could be doing so much more to impact the students and families in my community, and which is why I returned home to run for public office at State Center Community College District.
Oh, this is your
second. Okay. And I'll leave my comments there. I look forward to this conversation.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sheree Nicholson, and I'm running for State Center Community College District Trustee. Area 2. I don't know if you're aware, but it takes nearly 6 years for some of our students to graduate from a two-year college. And that work is really important to me because we have some of those same issues at Fresno State while I was a student. And so we created a retention program, which I was a coordinator for. And so I'm very familiar with working with students, finding barriers, and issues, and then creating innovative solutions for those barriers. And so there are a couple things I want to address on State Center. With my background in education and being an advocate, particularly in this community for the last decade, these things are really important for me. So you can hear more later. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Pat Yang. I'm running for the State Center Community College District 2. I'm blessed and honored to be here this morning to get invited. I've been in education, higher ed, for 17 years in the private sector, working, helping, enrolling students from the community colleges. So with my background in working with a diverse student population, especially from this community, in seeing what they go through at the K-12, in working with them when they finish the community colleges, I know what needs to be done. I know what help and transition needs to happen so that our students, our community can be successful. I'm from the community, been here since 1983. I have 5 kids. They're in elementary, middle school, high school, and college as well. My wife's a registered nurse. She went through the Fresno City College nursing program. I've taken courses and classes at community colleges. I'm here. I want to run this year because of my background, my experience, and I want my community to thrive. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is David Rowell. I want to thank BAPAC for putting on this forum. I want to thank Darren Miller, who I know because we're on the Simple Committee together. I also want to thank Cynthia Sterling, who I know. She's the treasurer of the Clovis Democratic Club, and I'm a member of that organization as well. I'm a candidate for the Board of Trustees for State Center Community College for District 6, a different district than these three individuals are running for. State Center is this huge district in the middle of the state, runs 6 campuses, has thousands and thousands of students. It's an important issue for this community and really everybody in Fresno County because it's an avenue for education, for economic well-being, and for social justice, which are all issues that I care about. So thank you very much. And I'll be speaking to those issues in a moment.
I wasn't sure if we were going to stand or sit, but I guess it's an individual matter. My name is Barbara Thomas, and I'm the incumbent of the Fresno County Board of Education. I'm in the middle of my 4th term and hoping to be reelected. My background is in special education, where I was the county administrator. I also have been a consultant for fiscal and crisis management assistance teams. So that gives you a little flavor of some of my expertise, so to speak. And I, like everyone else here, I'm very appreciative of your putting on this forum today, and I look forward to answering the questions.
Good morning, folks. Great to be here this morning. My name is Nelson Esparza. I am an educator in my district. I teach economics at Fresno City College. I'm chair of the Fresno County Young Democrats, and I am running for the Fresno County Board of Education and our district number 3. I'm running for the board in order to provide our students the opportunities and fundamental skills to succeed in our modern day 21st century. And to me, that's a mission that is very personal. The students in my district, I look like them. I grew up in the same circumstances as them. I was born to a young mother. We were low income, you know, had asthma, the whole Valley, Central Valley deal, right? Coming up as a student in our underserved communities. And so for me, it's a very personal to be running for this board and to be venturing out to serve and represent our students. Thank you.
Thank you to all of the candidates for being with us today. So our first question is going to be directed to the candidates for the State Center Community College District. And let's start the first question with candidate name. This is the question. What are the top 2 issues facing the State Center Community College District? And briefly explain how you plan to address them if elected into office.
Thank you. The first one is the graduation. My colleague here, Sherella, mentioned it takes about 6 years to graduate from a 2-year college. I see that as a huge issue. If elected, that would be my first priority to take a look at that, make sure that we are offering course specifics to the program so that students can graduate, make sure that we have access to those courses. We have the technology nowadays to offer online courses, morning, afternoon, evening, weekend courses so that students can access these courses so they can graduate and transfer within that 2 years that is intended by the state colleges. The second issue is making sure that our data collecting at the State Center is accurate. If you currently look at our scorecard, you look at the data, there's data, but the data is not accurate. We talk about equity. We talk about there's 6% African American students. We talked about 13% Asian Pacific Islander students. We talked about 45% Hispanic students. And then we talk about the other ethnic groups. So the data is not accurate. When I say it's not accurate, if we don't have accurate data, resources and allocations will not be given equitably to the different student or ethnic groups. And at the same time, looking at the regions of where these students are coming from. State Center is a huge, huge region in different sections of our county. So we gotta take a look at the data to make sure that we have accurate data so that we can provide the correct resources to the students that are from the region that are most needing of those resources. Thank you.
So there's two things that's happening. One, it's taking nearly 6 years for students to graduate. The students that are taking the longest to graduate are not coming in prepared. So there's some work that we need to do with the K-12 system to get our students prepared. So here's what I do. I sit on the school site council for Kirk Elementary. I volunteer my time at Gaston and Addison. I organize field trips. I work with teachers and administrators with the K-12 system already. So this is not something that I plan to do. These are things that I'm already doing that's preparing students for community college. I'm just not on the board yet. These are the things that we need to continue to do. We need to bridge the gap with the relationship between the K-12 administrators. Sit down, organize meetings. Let's talk about what the expectation is from the community college level. Let's see how we transfer that through the K-12 system. Let's not wait until these juniors and seniors and then they take the math and English exam and then they figure out that they're not ready. So then they get to community college and they're taking so many remedial classes and then it's taking 6 years. And then after that, they're not getting any more financial aid, and then it gets really expensive. So those are the things that we need to deal with. The second piece, the Central Valley is one of the poorest areas in the nation. The community college is responsible for training the workforce. We need to have a better relationship with our business and labor, figure out what's coming down the pipeline with high-speed rail, and better prepare our students for these classes. So those are the things that I will address immediately. Thank you.
I'm going to agree with my opponents on the dais that those are very important issues. Reducing our graduation or reducing our completion rates from 6 years to 2 years. And let me tell you what I've been able to do in the last 4 years. We've expanded educational access courses. We've hired over 40 full-time faculty members. We've re-implemented summer school offerings, and we've also expanded our online learning courses. And those all create access to educational opportunities. And as well as we have just now completed our bond measure. That's going to be another important issue that you're going to have to that I look forward to addressing during my re-election. We just passed a $485 million bond with the help of many of the people here in this room. And I felt that was important because coming from an urban community, a poor neighborhood here in West Fresno, I understand the value that a high quality education brings and having access to that education, which is why we will be implementing a new community college center here in West Fresno. Unprecedented. When many people said it could not be done, it's going to be done. Thank you.
David.
Sure. Well, first off, there's really three issues that I care about. And the number one issue, it seems to me, is centers around the faculty. Over the last number of years, the board has, or the administration has, concentrated primarily on hiring part-time faculty rather than tenured faculty. The education code requires a certain mix, and that mix is not being met. With the growth in the student population, the policies that the board has followed over the last couple of years, I think, are failing to address some important issues that center around faculty. That is, part-time faculty are not on campus, they're not doing committee work, they're not on providing office hours, students don't have access to them, so that I think is a real limitation on students' abilities to pursue their academic and career goals. I think it feeds into some of the issues that the other candidates are talking about. It takes 6 years instead of what should be a two-year program. I think that's very important. Another issue that is critically important is the change in the budgetary position of the district from $100 million to $485 million. The It's a tremendous influx of money. It's very important that that money be spent in the right way. The bond measure requires that it be spent on infrastructure, not on salaries. And I think making sure that that happens properly and that that money goes back into the local economy is critically important, that local people get hired for those jobs. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This next question is for the candidates of the Fresno County Office of Education. And let's start with Mr. Esparza. The question is, what are your thoughts on Common Core, and how is the Fresno County Office of Education using the new standard to address its diverse population?
So I can tell you that in my classroom and our community colleges, Fresno City College, all the students trickling into my classroom now, they are no child left behind students. They have been left behind, I'll tell you that. They have trouble thinking critically. Right? They want me to teach them to the test. They want to know, hey, what's going to be on the test? Is it going to be Scantron? And for a lot of it's a wake-up call when I say, you know, yeah, you have to memorize these facts, but you also are going to have to think critically, put the pieces of this puzzle together to solve this problem, you know, like you do, such as life. Common Core, I don't think it's been implemented long enough for us to really, the jury's still out there, right? But I think a departure from No Child Left Behind, particularly with the swing to the opposite direction of Common Core, is a very good thing. But again, I think we have to remain cognizant of the curriculum, making sure it's culturally appropriate so that each student has the opportunity to really succeed and understand and learn to think critically, right? So, I mean, the courses I teach here at City College, I used to teach, I taught at one time at UCLA, and where I had a lot more foreign students, particularly Japanese students, as I was saying. And so, you know, I would bring up examples and, you know, use part of the curriculum that, you know, an American person would understand to give an example. And I don't know if we have time to explain this, but, you know, I would have to frame things differently for those students so that they can understand, they have the opportunity to understand. And so I think, again, remaining cognizant of that as we continue to teach our students here in Fresno County.
Is this the one that's causing the problem?
It's not you guys at all, it's the system, so I apologize.
Is it on now?
Yes.
It's on now? Thank you. First of all, before I answer the question about Common Core, I think it's really important that everyone understands that a county board is not like a district board. Mm-hmm. County school boards have no students, we have no staff, we have no funding. Mm-hmm. Everything at the county office belongs to the county superintendent of schools. He runs the programs, he administers them, it's his responsibility. He serves poor community schools and the most medically fragile students. And as applied, the Common Core as applied to his programs, I will divide this into two issues. One is that when Common Core first started, our board was given intensive instruction, so if someone from the community wanted to know about it, we should explain it.
So my apologies, this building is 100 years old, and it gets kind of finicky at times, and that's an electrical feedback. So I am going to have to cut the system off, and I'm going to have to ask the candidates to use their outdoor voices. As well as those of you who are in the audience, if you are having difficulty hearing, I suggest that you come forward.
With regards to Common Core, the teachers under the superintendent have had extensive training in the standards so that they totally understand what is to be taught at each grade level. Given that our students are at-risk students, that curriculum and those standards need to be addressed individually with each student because they come in at very different places. So, but the other thing about the county program is that every student in the Court Community Schools have one-on-one computers so that they can be taught the technology to answer the questions on Common Core. Thank you.
Thank you very much. This next question will be for all of the candidates. We're going to go ahead and start with David Rohl this time. Who are your campaign's top three financial contributors?
All right, so my campaign's top three financial contributors are, number one, some local unions. I am supported by Local 1533, the State Center Federation of Teachers. It's the union to which faculty members at the State Center belong. I'm supported by the Fresno, Tulare, Kings, Madera, Central Labor Council, which is an affiliate of the AFL-CIO. I'm supported by the Carpenters Union. In addition to the funds that the unions are contributing, I'm investing a certain amount of my own money in it, and then sometime in the near future, I'm going to be holding a fundraiser. I hope to raise some funds from the community. That's it. Thank you.
My largest contributors, number one is the National Women's Political Caucus, which is a nonpartisan pro-choice women's organization. My second one is from the CBA PAC, which is the Progressive PAC. And my third is Dr. Alan Clyde, who is one of my colleagues on the county board. Most of my contributions are very small. Thank you.
I have over 150 different contributors. I would have to go back and look at my different reports. My operation is primarily grassroots driven, but if I had to think back, I would definitely say the Central Valley Progressive PAC is a large contributor. My good friend, Governor Michael Dukakis, and State Senator Trustee Miguel Arias is another contributor. But I mean, reports are public. I encourage you to take a look at our reports. We have another one coming out next week as well. Yes.
My top three. I don't look at it as top three. All my endorsement. My biggest endorser is the State Center Federation of Teachers Union. Dr. Barnes and that group has endorsed me based off of my experience, my work experience in education, the past 17 years, and my passion for education. Besides that, parents in the community have endorsed me. I've been blessed and fortunate enough to get sponsors and donations. I've raised close to $30,000 for this campaign. It's all from the community because they believe in me. They see that I can represent the community that I live in this district and the community at large. So, the teachers union and then parents in the community are my biggest endorsement.
I receive a number of endorsements and contributions too. One of the main ones are the National Women's Political Caucus. Community members, I have an dear friend, Cynthia George, are my main contributors. I've also contributed to my own campaign.
This has been a grassroots campaign for me. I'm valuing every vote and every contribution. I've had my neighbors, my friends, all contribute amounts from $5 to $3,000 because they believe in the work that I've done and that I'll continue to do. I've been endorsed by local unions, the sheet metal workers, as well as small business owners like like Blue Ocean Development. As well as local educators in our K-12 system who are strong partners in the work for dual enrollment, like Vincent Harris. So I'm proud to say that many of my campaign contributions have been many of my neighbors and friends here in the community.
Great, thank you. The next question is for the candidates State Center. We'll start with Ms. Nicholson. What are your thoughts on tenured versus non-tenured faculty positions?
So the way the system is, the model that State Center has now, it's an inequity system and it perpetuates barriers that students have to succeed. Right now there's about 70% part-time adjunct faculty and 30% are full-time tenured. And so what that looks like
for one, for the faculty members, the non-tenured faculty do not receive the same type of benefits. They don't receive the same type of pay. They don't receive the same type of office hours on campus. So one, that's an equity for the hours that they're working compared to the same amount of hours at a full-time tenured. Two, it creates a problem for students to have access to their professors. If a student has questions on math problem, they need extra help, they want to review something, the part-time faculty do not have office hours and an office for them, for the students to be able to have access to them. So that creates a problem. They're the lifeline to our students. They're the front contact for our students. And if they're not available, then that creates a problem, and then that creates a district-wide inequity for all of our campuses. So those are things that I'd like to see addressed immediately.
First of all, I really want to educate some of the folks that are here to make sure that they're getting the correct information. Because it's all about ensuring that we understand what's being said to us. And one of those things is that we're a tenured system. And so understanding that there is a differentiation between part-time faculty and full-time faculty, we are a tenured full-time faculty system. Also understanding that we're a merit-based system. And so we work in collaboration with many of our unions that are represented in our system. And I think it's important that you understand that and that you know that information is available to you. And then secondly, that these issues are not exclusive only to State Center Community College District. These issues impact an entire system across the California Community College System. And you have practitioners like myself who are working with the California State Legislature to address these issues. There are a number of bills in the legislature right now working to address our part-time faculty representatives that are teaching. So I would definitely say it's important that we educate ourselves on the facts.
Yeah, my thoughts on tenure, non-tenure, as an adjunct faculty myself, I teach business and leadership courses at the college level. I try to put as much commitment as a full-time faculty, but because I'm stretched thin as a part-time faculty, I can't commit as much to my student and to the college that I teach at. So, my comment on that is we need to have more full-time faculty so that they can be accessible to the students. Granted, we have amazing part-time faculty. They're teaching because they're passionate about what they do. They love the students, they want to be there, but because they're stretched thin, it's a lot harder to provide the services at the level that the full-time can provide. So that's my thought on it. If we can get more part-time, we need to take a look at the budgets that we have and focus on more part-time so that they can be more available. It's not that they don't commit as much, it's that they're stretched thin. That's my thought on this. Thank you.
My thoughts are consistent with what these folks have to say. I think the current mixture of non-tenured versus tenured is wrong. I think it's contrary to the numbers that are set out in the education code. I don't know if that makes it against the law. People like to say things are against the law, but there's a mix that's set out in the education code, and State Center isn't meeting that mix. It's primarily wrong because it's unfair to students. They don't have access to the faculty, to the counseling, to the stuff that they need to get the programs sufficiently. It's unfair to the faculty who are never being paid much, much less than full-time faculty for teaching the same classes. That's wrong. The student population is growing. The faculty will be growing. There's going to be a tremendous influx of money, not only because of Measure C, but because of the high-speed rail. We can expect the whole system to grow. It's important that when it does grow, it reflects the community that we're teaching. Diversity is a real issue on the faculty, and I think that needs to be addressed as well. So.
Thank you very much. This next question is for the Fresno County Office of Education candidates, starting with Ms. Thomas. There's a current lack of teachers and teachers' aides in Fresno County K-12 schools. Taking into account the increasingly diverse student population, What is your four-year plan to increase the diverse educational workforce as it relates to our students?
This is my passion. California is very underfunded. We are 50th in the nation in terms of teacher to students, in terms of counselors to students. The change cannot be made locally. It has to be made at the state to get more funding into our system. Texas has 42,000 more teachers than California. California serves 1.4 million more students. And this is ridiculous. I've been working with the California State School Boards because I was elected to be the Fresno representative. And they have set out a plan to try to get this additional funding within the next 4 years. So I would like to continue my position in order to continue working with state coalitions to take care of this. And one other thought with regards to the diverse population, which was your question. We used to be able to offer stipends so that we could get a diverse teaching corps. We don't have the money to do that anymore.
So as Trustee Thomas has implied, that is, this question is a bit out of the purview of your standard Fresno County Board of Education trustee. But I'm glad you asked it because I for one, am committed to being a voice for those things that I cannot be a vote on. And that includes, you know, using your influence, working with all different levels of government, from your county board trustee to your council members to your state assembly member to your congressman, to get things done, to bring ideas to the table and work across those aisles. This issue is primarily a state issue. So we do have a shortage of teachers, you know, statewide, but you know, everything in Fresno just happens to be worse than it is everywhere else in California, right? So we're more heavily here, impacted here in Fresno County, especially in our rural areas, not just our urban core. And I mean, this question can go in a lot of different directions. This has to do with our teacher engines. So in our master plan for higher education in California, our CSUs are our teacher engines. We have our local teacher engine here in Fresno, CSU Fresno. So it's not just a question of funding, right? But I mean, it is pay for teachers, teacher retention, teacher curriculum, all sorts of different issues. So, I mean, again, I wouldn't have a four-year plan. I mean, out of the purview, but I am committed to working across different jurisdictions to see if we can move the ball on bringing more teachers, retaining those teachers, and having them be able to work with that diverse student population that we have here in Fresno County.
Thank you very much. This question is for all of the candidates. We're going to start here at the end of the table with Eric Payne. What is one major problem in the State Center Community College District or for our other candidates in the Fresno County Office of Ed that you feel needs to be addressed day one when you become trustee?
I'm going to say that bond implementation. We just received $485 million from the taxpayers. And we have a number of projects that need to be implemented, from a new STEM facility at Fresno City College, additional parking at Fresno City College. We will be upgrading our technology infrastructure, where we've invested millions of dollars. When I came to the system in 2012, our system was, technology was antiquated. Now we've reached a point to where we're going to be cutting edge. We've made significant investments in our technology infrastructure, and we'll continue to make those investments with our bond money. As well as, again, the new West Fresno facility that will be built here in West Fresno. Again, when they said it could not be done, it's happening. And so those are just a few of my priorities, as well as the new police and fire academy in Southeast Fresno. We made a commitment to voters prior to my arrival to the board, and I want to make sure that we execute that with the match funding that we've received from our local bond measure. And I've held our administrators accountable to completing those projects, and I'll continue to do so.
One major problem that I see that needs needs to be addressed immediately with State Center Community College District. It's certainly a vision. And so with any organization, there needs to be a vision between the chancellor, the district's president, and the boards. And so right now, they are not aligned, which is why we have so many issues that we need to deal with. And that takes good communication. The current work that I do now is creating strategic partnerships for distressed neighborhoods in the city of Fresno with the mayor's office and the rest of the council. None of the work gets done without a strategic plan to meet those needs and getting folks in the room to communicate. We are seeing that Black males are taking the longest to graduate from this community that are not being properly addressed because people don't have the courage and capacity to step up and advocate for the community that they serve. We are seeing that the K-12 system, there's a disconnect between that and the board. That needs to be addressed. So while the State Center is doing such a great job and yes, has passed the bond for $485 million, there are things that are still not being properly addressed, and that's what I will do when I, on day one.
Yeah, now for me, I was at DeVry University for 15 years, Fremont, Bay Area. Students from the Valley would move over there. It costs a lot to live in the Bay Area, go to school. So my goal was, what can I do to help this community here? We brought DeVry University here. And then I took DeVry University to Bakersfield as well. So my priority is, you know what, my district too, especially we got the bond money, we have the Southwest Center as a priority. That would be my priority, is taking that education here. If you take a look at this community, it's tough for us to send our kids there. It's tough for our kids to get to the Fresno City College, the Madera, the Clovis community, the Oakhurst, and the Reedley. So that's my priority, because it's on their priority already. The bond money is there. Let's make that a priority, and let's focus on one thing at a time, and that is important, because if we don't bring the education to our community, they're going to take it elsewhere, and they will continue to upgrade infrastructure. An analogy that I use to the voter is, we don't even have a big screen TV here, but they're upgrading their 50-inch to a 60-inch. And that's an issue that I have. That would be my priority. Thank you.
It seems to me that the central issue, and it really bears on all the other issues that we've talked about, is implementing a policy that lets students get in and out of the college in the 2 years that it is intended that they should complete. There's many different aspects of that. One is as Shirela talked about, working with the K-12 community. Students arrive at the college, they think they've taken classes that will suffice for college level classes, they're not, and so they end up having to retake English 1A or whatever they're calling it now, the entry level English class, which they thought they'd taken, but they haven't, so they have to take remedial classes. At the other end, students take classes which they think will prepare them for a 4-year university, they don't. Whether it's access to the classes, access to the faculty, providing the proper classes that the students need. For various issues, it's taking too long, and I think that's the most important issue, is allowing students to get through the program in the time that they have to do it.
Well, whether re-elected or not re-elected, my top priority, for the sake of the kids, is our funding problems. I will be advocating for the bond issue. You heard both Clovis and Central say how desperately they need buildings. The Fresno County Superintendent has been very active in getting this bond on the ballot. I'll be advocating for Proposition 55, which is the extension of the dollars from Proposition 30. And so those are, that's what my priority will be, is to advocate.
So within the purview of a Fresno County Board trustee, in my opinion, the single most important thing a trustee can do each year, each fiscal year, is cast a vote on the budget. And so the question I'm asking, and I don't know the answer yet, is, are we serving students to the very best of our ability?
In my district, there minimum 84% of our students are land in one or more disadvantaged categories, low income, foster youth, English learners, migrant students, or special ed, and with many students overlapping in several of those different areas. So I'd say my number one priority would just be, again, since the most important thing I can do as a trustee is cast a vote on that budget, is to look at the allocations and again determine whether we are serving students to the best of our ability. And if not, then voice my concerns and see, if, I mean, have my input heard when the final budget is voted on.
Thank you very much. This will be the final question before you have an opportunity to make a closing remark. Again, this question is for all of the candidates. We will start at the end of the table with Mr. Sparza and move our way back over this time. As
sure, sure.
You're on twice.
back to back.
How do you feel the state, I'm sorry, excuse me, how do you feel the high-speed rail's monetary infusion will impact Fresno County Office of Ed or State Center, will impact their educational curriculum?
Well, I mean, it's going to impact our entire county with respect to the education curriculum. I mean, we have to adjust, we have to provide.